वॉट इज हिलेरियस इज दैट वाइल द कंपनीज सर्वेंट्स देवर थ्राइविंग देवर गेटिंग फॉर्च्यून्स, कंपनी की हालत बिगड़ती जा रही है. कंपनी वॉज इन ए स्टेट ऑफ बैंक्रप्सी, बैंक्रप्ट कंडीशन. दे वर अंडर द डेट ऑफ £6 million. दे अप्लाइड टू गवर्नमेंट फॉर ए लोन ऑफ £10 million. Hello friends, my name is Deepak and I am teaching history optional and GS history in Plutus IAS. So as regards to this topic, the constitutional developments, I have taken Regulating Act of 1773. Okay, so before getting into the topic, let me give you a brief idea of what was happening or what was the background of the topic. Okay, so you have seen that East India Company was inch by inch, it was closing near territory of India, and they have got, soon they have got Farman from Farrukh Siyar and they have started trading. But in the name of trading, they have started certain mal practices like abuse of dastak. Dastak. Dastak were private passes. They were passes given to the government officials, but these government officials, they used to sell them to the private persons. So what was happening? That the government of England was not gaining anything in return, but the private traders from Britain, they were gaining. So it was a loss of Indian government also, and it was a loss of government of England. Fine. Now, historical background. So now we come close towards our topic. So the historical background of the topic says the Battle of Buxar. It mentioned about Battle of Buxar. This battle was happened in 1764. This battle was happened in 1764 and it was a very decisive battle, because it is said that it is not a Plassey plunder, but the Battle of Buxar, which decided the course of British paramountcy in India. British paramountcy, that British are going to have paramount power over India or not. Okay, so in this battle, English East India was on one side and it was fighting Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II, Nawab of Awadh, Shujauddin, and Mir Qasim from Munger. ओके, लेटर ही टुक हिज कैपिटल टू मुर्शिदाबाद। सो रिमेंबर दीज नेम्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ प्रिलिम्स। ओके, so what was happening that the Diwan of Bengal, he got defeated in this war, and as a result the company it got Diwani rights in Bengal, Bihar and Odisha. During that time Odisha was also a part of Bengal province, so Diwani rights of Odisha were also conferred to the company along with the Bengal and Bihar. Okay, so Nawab of Bengal, he remained merely a titular head, that is for the namesake. This we are discussing the background of the Regulating Act of 1773. Why need arose for Government of England to frame such legislative enactment? There must be some issues. History is all about cause and effect. You should know the causes and you should know the effects also. Okay? There is always a causal relationship between the events. So, Nijamat means, by Nijamat we means administration, governance, administration. Or governance. Except revenue collection. Except revenue collection. So revenue collection किसके पास जा रहा है? Revenue collection was given to the English East India Company. And administration governance is going to two Indians appointed as deputy Diwans. Okay, Nijamat too is to be controlled indirectly through two Indians appointed as deputy Diwans. Their names are important from prelims point of view. Muhammad Raza Khan and Raja Shitab Rai for Bihar. Okay. So Nijamat is to be indirectly controlled. What British did? They took two men of their choice and they set them as two deputy Diwans and they were given charge of everything. Okay. So this arrangement was created by Lord Clive, and this arrangement was made after battle of Buxar. So it must be from 1765. Till the coming of Regulating Act. Regulating Act came in 1773. So by logic it started in 1765 and by logic it was discontinued in 1772. Okay, fine. So fine, is that clear? So now let me discuss some nuances of the dual system of this government. There are certain anomalies also related to associated with this dual system of government, which falsified the notion of introducing it. Okay. That became its undoing. Oh, fine. So the dual system of government, under the dual system of government 1765 to 1772, the company had the authority but no responsibility, and Indian representative, they had responsibility but no authority. It's very obvious that Britain has, after victory over Bengal, after British got the Diwani rights over Bengal, British had immense revenues in their hands. Immense revenue means they had immense power in their hand, and now they will use this power to launch attack over other Indian powers, which they did. Okay, if you have gone through the previous year questions, then there is a question that neither Alexander nor Napoleon could have succeeded against a power commanding Bengal seas. Means a power which has command over Bengal, the rich province of Bengal. It was a power to reckon with. It is almost impossible to defeat such power which is sitting in Bengal, and that's what happened. Why French were defeated, why Marathas were defeated, why Mysore was defeated, that explain the richness of Bengal. So under the dual system, company had authority but no responsibility. So no authority, they will be responsible for nothing. Whatever mayhem has been created due to them or due to the arrangements made by the Britain, but they had no responsibility. The responsibility has to be entrusted to the two Diwans, the two unlucky chaps. So it continued for 7 years. Remember it as a statement for prelims. It continued for 7 years, and excessive revenue collection and oppression of peasantry. For peasantry of Bengal, this arrangement was very exploitative, since the British officials and the private traders coming from England, they had little sympathy with the peasantry and artisanry. So what they did, they were overburdened. It lead to pauperization of peasantry. It lead to destruction of handicrafts of Bengal, traditional handicrafts of Bengal. Artisans lost their job. Cultivator lost their land. It was a peasant type. It was almost akin. The situation was almost akin to peasantization of economy. Peasantization of economy. Use such words in during your mains writing, because it shows your caliber to understand the concept, to grasp the concept, and it also shows that you know about the vocab of your subject. Vocab of subject is very important. The answer which you are writing for Regulating Act in GS history is not similar to the answer which you are writing in a history optional. it will be average answer. Okay, and you will get below average marks for that. Okay. So, rampant corruption was there. It was very obvious that rampant corruption. Now, corruption will rule the roost because companies, servants, be it private, trading to amass personal wealth, massive wealth was generated, but all it went to pockets of private companies, private traders. You know about company? Company was a joint stock company. तो इन्होंने पैसा लगाया है तो अब उनको ज्यादा से ज्यादा रिटर्न चाहिए. ओके, सो द सिचुएशन वॉज सच. व्हाट इज हिलेरियस इज दैट व्हाइल द कंपनीज सर्वेंट्स देवर थ्राइविंग, देवर गेटिंग फॉर्च्यून्स, कंपनी की हालत बिगड़ती जा रही है. कंपनी वॉज इन ए स्टेट ऑफ बैंकरप्ट कंडीशन. दे वर अंडर द डेट ऑफ £6 million. दे अप्लाइड टू गवर्नमेंट फॉर ए लोन ऑफ £10 million. उनको लोन के लिए अप्लाई करना पड़ा. दे हैड टू अप्लाई फॉर लोन. सच अ पुअर पिक्चर ऑफ करप्शन एंड बेईमानी, हिंदी में बोलेंगे कि बेईमानी की भी हद है ना. सो कलकत्ता काउंसिल, तो कोर्ट ऑफ डायरेक्टर, व्हाट दे डिड, दे टुक द डिसीजन. कोर्ट ऑफ डायरेक्टर मींस द कोर्ट ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स ऑफ द कंपनी. दे टुक द इन द बैकड्रॉप ऑफ दिस व्हाट वाज हैपनिंग, दे डिसाइडेड टू डिसकंटिन्यू द सिस्टम, द डुअल सिस्टम व्हिच वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय लॉर्ड क्लाइव, नाउ डिसकंटिन्यूड ड्यूरिंग वॉरेन हेस्टिंग्स टेन्योर. रिमेंबर दिस, व्हेनेवर दिस क्वेश्चन वाज आस्क्ड, the dual government system was, it was introduced by Lord Clive, but it ended during Warren Hastings' tenure, and Warren Hastings' tenure also marked the coming up of Regulating Act of 1773. Okay, he was the first Governor General under that setup. So both the deputy diwans, they had to go. It was very obvious that they had to go. Also, I told you about the peasantization of economy, the poor condition of Bengal peasantry, overburdening of the traditional handicrafts, the destruction of traditional handicrafts. So the composite effect, the composite effect of this was famine of Bengal. If famine of Bengal in 1770, and it was a picture of complete collapse of governance. अब क्या था, ब्रिटिश के गवर्नमेंट को एक बहाना भी मिल गया कि ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी तो यार क्या कर रहा है, what they are doing, they look at the poor people. 1770 famine was an eye opener for them that what they are doing, they are simply mismanaging the things. So they took over the administration from them slowly, gradually, through a series of acts, and the beginning with the Regulating Act. Also, Haider Ali was ruler of Mysore. So in 1781 battle, in 1781 battle and 1782 battle, during Anglo-Mysore Wars, British faces certain reversals, and due to those reversals, the British government, they were concerned that they are in a position to lose their control over India, such a rich country, सोने के चिड़िया. In this backdrop, the British government decided to bring some order, into the company's affairs, and passed by a British Parliament as North Regulating Act. Why we call it as North Regulating Act? Because Lord North was Prime Minister of England at that point of time. You in American Revolution, you will also heard this name, Lord North. For all bad things. So in this backdrop, and to bring some order, the British, and to control, to rein in company, British government, it brought North Regulating Act. Now let's look at the basic features of Regulating Act. So provisions of Regulating Act of 1773, or rather North's Regulating Act of 1773. So remodeling of the constitution of the company both in England and India. So it remodeled the constitution of the company. Constitution of the company. Company had certain constitution. It was run by a court of directors. So now the changes were introduced over there, both in England and both in India. And in England, the right to vote in court proprietors, the owners of the company, their court was separate. So the right to vote कि अब हम छोटे लोगों को नहीं देंगे, अब बड़े लोगों को ही देंगे. So this was raised from 500 to 1000 pound. So those who had this capacity could vote in court of proprietors. And there would, from now onwards, there would be elections every year. And for 4 years, number was fixed at 24, and 1/4 would be retiring every year. The house was the case is similar to Rajya Sabha, our present Rajya Sabha. So they are like 1/4 of the people were retiring. And they, so 6 are left, but since the tenure is for 4 years, so 24 years tenure was ensured. So these were the provisions. Also, the directors of the company required to submit all correspondence regarding revenue affairs and civil military administration to the government. Directors of the company, now the directors of the company, I told you about the court of directors, now they were compelled to submit all correspondence regarding revenue or military regarding India, or regarding what is happening, or these aspects which were revenue and military aspects in India, all correspondence in relation to that they had to submit to the British government. So Don't you guess that it was for the first time right of control, it was trying to control Indian affairs. अभी तक तो ब्रिटेन शांत बैठा हुआ था कि इंग्लिश इंग्लिश ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी इज डूइंग देयर जॉब वेल नाउ, बट दिस वाज द फर्स्ट टाइम दे आर इंसिस्टिंग देयर राइट टू इंटरफेयर और रेदर राइट टू डोमिनेट इंडियन अफेयर्स कंपनीज इंडियन अफेयर्स. Okay, so I told you that the changes were brought in England. In England, the code of proprietors, the right to vote, the eligibility criteria was changed. And here in India, certain changes were brought. So in India, the collegiate government of Bengal was changed. The collegiate system of Bengal was introduced in Bengal. So Warren Hastings was appointed as the first Governor General of Bengal or Fort William. Remember, he was not first Governor General of India. He was first Governor General of Fort William. Okay, so he had a council also, and in that council there were four members, and president of that council is the fifth member, who is himself is a governor general. Okay, but as we see, since there were five members, so majority rule would be applicable. Okay, so majority law. Okay, so out of five were favoring certain decision, then the decision would be the same only, would go in that direction only. So later on, casting vote to the Governor General was given. Okay, but the three members form the quorum. At least three members were required to form the quorum. Otherwise, there won't be any sitting of council. And this happened. This was actually happening in this case, because Philip Francis, Clavering, Monson, and Borwell, all of them, they clashed with Warren Hastings. They tried to bring him down. They tried to blemish his tenure. So what they did, this council became a specter of ego clashes, okay, which inadvertently influenced the functioning of councils as well. Okay, so civil and military government of Fort William presidency in Bengal vested in this council. Okay, another feature, first feature, Governor General and his council. Second feature, Supreme Court of Judicature was set up in 1774 with Sir Eliza Impey as the Chief Justice. However, what it was a Supreme Court, but jurisdiction was defined in such a manner that it was always in debate. There were certain cases where it gave capital punishment, okay, and that capital punishment was countered by the local court, okay. So local custom courts were there. So it came, and its jurisdiction was always found to be overlapping with the local custom courts or local religious courts. Okay, and it was found to be a case of judicial overreaching. So the Supreme Court of this is a major criticism against this Supreme Court of Judicature. And Governor General could exercise some power over Bombay and Madras. Bombay and Madras, these were another two presidencies. But what was happening earlier, instead of bringing a crucial or very concrete control over Bombay and Madras, instead a loose control of Bengal Governor General was ensured through this act. Okay, so this act also worked on the principle of checks and balances. How checks and balances? Because on one side, Governor General in Council has to frame the laws, and on the other side, Supreme Court of Judicature has to frame the laws. ठीक है? तो both will frame the laws, and both were on paper at least. The system was good on paper. The system functioning and the system did not function well. That is a separate thing. But on paper, the system was perfect. Okay. It was based on the principle of checks and balance, which should be there in any governmental setup. Okay. So salaries were became more now more liberal, so that liberals, in the case of liberal salaries, there won't be any more corrupt practices by the company's servants. Okay, so fundamental principles of honest administration were laid out by this. So these were the provisions of Regulating Act of 1773. Now we will discuss assessment or our verdict on the Regulating Act of 1773. So the act was in operation for 11 years, and it continued till Warren Hastings was there as Governor General to administer. The system broke down completely when put into practice. Why? Why I told you? Because the Governor General, he was emasculated due to majority rule. The majority rule principle was an irritant for Governor General. Okay. Insufficient authority over Bombay presidency and मद्रास प्रेसिडेंसी, जिसको जो मन में आ रहा है वो करे जा रहा है, सुप्रीम कोर्ट को जो मन में आ रहा है करे जा रहा है, गवर्नर जनरल के इन काउंसिल के काउंसिल मेंबर्स जो हैं के मन में जो आ रहा है, ही दे आर डूइंग व्हाट एवर दे वांट. सो गवर्नर जनरल किस लिए बनाया है ना? सो द सिस्टम ब्रोक आउट इन प्रैक्टिस बिकॉज इट इमैस्कुलेटेड गवर्नर जनरल. This is the thing which they are going to do away in the near future, okay, by the series of acts. So Supreme Court, it administered English laws, but it had anomalous relation with the country courts. I told you that the local custom courts, the country courts, it often came into clash with it. So its functions and powers were not delineated properly. Okay. But still, despite the fact that there were so many anomalies, so many shortcomings, so many weaknesses of regulating acts were there, and Parliament corrected them in the coming future through series of other acts, but still the Regulating Act of 1773, it holds some significance. Let's look at the significance of एक्ट ऑफ 1773। इट वॉज फर्स्ट सीरियस अटेम्प्ट, रिमेंबर फर्स्ट सीरियस अटेम्प्ट, फर्स्ट सीरियस अटेम्प्ट टू ऑर्गेनाइज पावर। डिटेल्स वर लेफ्ट टू द कंपनी, डिटेल्स वर लेफ्ट टू द कंपनी, पर एट द सुपरफिशियल लेवल द पार्लियामेंट, द ब्रिटिश पार्लियामेंट, दे हैव इंडिकेटेड टू द कंपनी दैट यू हैव टू फॉलो दिस डायरेक्शन, ऑल दो डिटेल्स वर नॉट वर्कड आउट प्रॉपरली। सुप्रीम कोर्ट टू चेक द अब्यूज ऑफ अथॉरिटी कंपनी सर्वेंट्स, सुप्रीम कोर्ट रिमेन देयर एंड इट कंटिन्यू टू चेक द केसेज ऑफ अब्यूज ऑफ अथॉरिटी बाय द कंपनी सर्वेंट्स। सो दिस वॉज ए नोवल स्टेप, दिस वॉज ए नोवल स्टेप, सिंस सच सेटअप वॉज नॉट देयर इवन इन इंडिया। कोर्ट्स, the sultan or the rulers, they were almost free. Muftis or sadar, they had no control over sultan. Sultan or badshah means state, and state means law. To jo sultan bolega, jawabit bolte hain medieval mein, wahi jo hai laws hai. So it was a good attempt to provide honest and efficient administration. It was an honest attempt, good attempt to provide an honest and efficient administration. However, the act was not attuned to the local problems. Not attuned to the local problem means local problems were different. Local problems was about mismanagement, corruption by the private servant, burdening peasantry, peasantization of economy, Bengal famine. Bengal was becoming poor very soon, exhausted, its economy is getting exhausted and very soon at such a pace. So those issues remain untouched. Only the peripheral issues, they were only touched upon, which is going to favor company only. And so it was a remedial and supplementary legislation, a kind of in 1781 anomalies of 1773 were tried to be done away with introduction of amending act of 1781. Okay, so a remedial and supplementary legislation was introduced, and jurisdiction of the Supreme Court was defined by through this legislation within Calcutta, that Supreme Court has to function within Calcutta and nowhere else, okay, and to administer the personal law of the defendant. Personal law. So two things were important in this: Calcutta and the personal law. It has to function within the Calcutta, and it has to administer personal laws. Okay. So this is all about regulating Act of 1773. It was a first serious attempt to regulate companies' affair in India. Okay. So in this context, in this backdrop, this topic become very important to discuss. Okay, in future lectures or in future discussion, we would be discussing many more acts. Okay, till then, all the best. Good luck.